thank you for coming today. I'm Attorney Gloria Allred. And today is the 40th anniversary of the January 22nd, 1973 United States Supreme Court decision, Roe v. Wade. And prior to 1973, many states in the United States made abortion a crime or severely restricted it. Roe v. Wade held that a woman has a constitutional right to choose abortion. That right cannot be restricted or prohibited at certain stages of her pregnancy. Prior to 1973, many women died or were maimed by illegal abortions. Many hemorrhaged or bled to death from illegal abortions, which were performed in back alleys and in other unsanitary places by individuals who had no medical training and who did it for the money. I was one of those women who didn't die, but who almost bled to death. After I was raped at gunpoint in the 1960s, I became pregnant and returned to the United States. I obtained an abortion from someone who performed an abortion on me and then fled. I developed a severe infection, had a fever of 106 degrees, and had to be taken to the hospital, hemorrhaging and almost dying. Fortunately for me, I was packed on ice and the doctor saved my life. Millions of women in this nation suffered similar horror to the one that I suffered. This is why so many women today are pro-choice and are strongly committed to keeping abortion safe and legal. We want to be sure that our daughters, their daughters, are never forced to suffer in the way that we do. Fortunately, however, ever since Roe v. Wade was decided, the decision to protect the right to choose abortion has been under attack in the streets, in the courts, in the state legislatures, and in Congress. Constant efforts to eliminate or restrict that constitutional right continue. For example, today, in approximately 87% of all of the counties in the United States, a woman has no access to abortion because doctors and healthcare providers have been terrorized and sometimes murdered. And that statistic is from NARAL, Pro-Choice, National Abortion Rights Action.
Vermont, station.
Restriction of this right particularly hurts the poor and the young, and it should not be tolerated. Today I mark this 40th anniversary by giving my own blood to symbolize the blood that women and girls will need if, as and when, Roe is undermined. Women's blood will be on the hands of those who continue to attack this constitutional right to choose abortion. No woman or girl should ever be forced to risk their life in order to obtain an abortion. On this 40th anniversary, I and many other women are committed to keeping abortion safe and legal and available, and never again allowing abortion to be made illegal and dangerous to the life, to the health, and to the safety of our mothers, our sisters,